I sometimes think that one of the best compliments I ever had is from somebody who thought I was a total jerk at work. He once said to someone else, my boss at the time, that you could say what you like about Christine Armstrong. And clearly he had everything to say about Christine Armstrong and how dreadful she was. But people really like working for her. And he was enormously surprised by this. And it is partly true. I've got a very treasured, small but treasured collection of handwritten letters from people who did apparently really enjoy working for me. But here's the thing. I also have a much longer list of people who thought that working with me was an absolute bloody nightmare from start to finish. See you next Friday.
See you next week.
See you next Friday.
See you next week. See you next week.
See you next week. See you next week. See you next week. And it's in that context that I've been reading Tessa West, Jerks at Work this week. And here is my take on Jerks at Work and Tessa's book. Seven different kinds of jerks. You've got your bulldozers, you've got your micromanagers, you've got neglectors, you've got credit stealers. There's a lot of information there and there's a lot of strategies to cope with them. What I see in those behaviours is lots of people who do that stuff, but they tick three or four of the different categories. And also that they change categories depending on the context that they're in. So when I did a speech about bullying a few years ago, and I spoke to loads of people about their experiences of bullying, one of them said, do you want to know about the time that I was a bully or when I was bullied? My experience is that there are key drivers to how people behave at work. It may be fear, loss of control, loss of status. It may be a grasp for power, probably a bit of both going on at the same time. It may be that people have tuned out completely because they're not being seen, they're not heard, they're not in the right job. But those underlying things are driving more of those behaviors than the core seven. And finally, my big problem with this is when I read those categories, I think, but I do loads of those things. You do loads of those things. Tessa's constantly admitting in the book that she does them. And it made me wonder whether describing jerks at work as jerks is actually helpful. Because aside a couple of total psychopaths, most of us are deeply flawed and we're all trying to figure it out. And there are people who find it easy to work with us and people who don't. So perhaps the most useful thing is to understand the ways in which we're a jerk, the kind of people who find it most difficult to work with us, and perhaps the language and conversations to change that dynamic. Interested in your thoughts? Perhaps I'm being too rosy. But I'm going to see you next Friday if we survive the wild winds. See you then.